What's up guys, I'm Bassem Abu Jaber, fashion and beauty photographer. Today I want to show you how I edit this picture. Before we begin, if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button to not miss any video coming. So let's get started. First thing, this before, this after. Before, after, let's go closer. Little bit. Okay, this before, this after. Okay, let's jump to camera roll. First thing, I want to adjust the white balance. White balance is most important thing in your photo to do it right. So how you do it? You adjust it like back and forth, like this, to see the sweet spot. 5400 is good for this picture. Tint, zero is good. Exposure plus 10. Highlight minus 14. Shadow plus 25, white minus 26. I open a little bit the black plus 3, and clarity plus 5. And here I reset everything. In the hue I put minus 2. The saturation I put plus 3 in the orange, minus 12 in the yellow, and here plus 4. That's it for here. Let's see before and after. This before, this after. So let's jump to Photoshop. First thing, I want to jump to liquify and filter. Liquify. And first I want to fix a little bit the jawline here. I like to do it a little bit like V shape, but in gentle way. I didn't like to do too much. Something like this. This the before after. A little bit I want to fix the hair. I want to make it round, a little bit round shape, a little bit volume, and also the hand a little bit. And here a little bit. And that's it here. Let's jump to Photoshop. So guys, now I want to begin dodging and burning. So first thing, I have some action here. I didn't want to do it from the beginning. So let's begin, and I have a black and a white layer to let me see better the problem. So let's begin painting. I use also soft brush. It at 2%. And this process will take time a little bit. I'll take about 30 minutes, maybe less, maybe more. It depends on the photo, so I want to speed up this process. So now I finished that cleaning and dodging and burning. This is the before and after. Before, after, as you see. And I darken a little bit the background. And I change eye color. If you like to know how I change eye color, I have tutorial coming about changing eye color. So make sure to didn't miss any new tutorial coming. So let's now jump to the most important part, is color grading. I choose a selective color and I go to the red and I put in the red 20 in the red and I darken it a little bit, plus 10 in the black, and in the yellow I put plus 2 also, and in the yellow I put plus 14, and in the cyan I put plus 6, and then I go to the white, I put little bit cyan, 6% plus 6, and in the yellow I didn't want 0, I think 0 is better. Okay, 0. And in the neutral I want to put little bit magenta, I think 2 magenta, 1 magenta, and 1, or I think 2 in the yellow is better for this picture, and 0 in the cyan. And now I go to the black, I put 1 in the cyan, and 2 in the magenta, and 2 in the yellow. And that's it for jump to the curve. I put little bit cyan in the white. I like always to put little bit cyan in the red. Okay, and this I put in the group together and see before and after what I did. This is the before, this is after. As you see, huge difference. So I take black and white and I put it in soft light. I put it in 10% the opacity. And then I go to the curve and I bring it up in the mid-tone and bring up also the black, and in the shadow I bring it down. As you see, you can take your time in your curve because very sensitive the curve, so make sure to. And in the dark shadow I bring it a little bit up. And this is the before after. I lower the opacity a little bit, about 72. And this is the before and after. So guys, this is the final image. Let's see before and after. This before, this after, before, after. I hope you like it. If you like, please subscribe to my channel and hit double button to not miss any video coming. And see you on the next video.